it can take a short pass and do a lot of damage with it.
Fans in Detroit chanting Calvin. He's 25 yards away.
This man is clearly, by far, the most gifted receiver who has ever come along in the history of this league.
Into the record books. NFL receiving yardage record.
You too. Happy July 4th. Welcome one, welcome all. This is more commentary, more straight talk with Avery Giovanni. I am your host, and this is Spirit of Detroit podcast. I hope y'all enjoyed your holidays. Got a little busy with mine. Got a little more busy than what I would like. But always, you know, we're just going to keep videos coming regularly, no matter what. Sun, sleet, rain, or shine. And I had thought some time ago to make a video, and I just couldn't hold it in. So originally, this video was going to go out around August 1st, because the Hall of Fame game was going to come up. Hall of Fame indoctrination is going to come up. And Alan Faneca, Calvin Johnson, you know, we got a bunch of guys going in. Guys I grew up watching, which was unbelievable. guys I ended up watching, you know, it's August 8th, and I was probably going to put together a video or something the week of. I'd rather do things 2 weeks ahead. And this is one of my easier videos. So I just had to put it out a little early. I mean, it's interesting. I mean, you got John Lynch, Peyton Manning, Bill Nunn. I mean, this is just amazing, man. Charles Woodson, Tom Flores. Come on, man. We know. We here. But we're about to get into Calvin Johnson today. See, everybody else in that list have won a Super Bowl. Everybody else in that list been a part of storied organizations. Everybody else in that list won in some capacity. Whether it was Alan Faneca on that, you know, 2008 Steelers team and 2006 Steelers team and the damn Arizona Cardinals team he was on. Or it was Lynch, who won a Super Bowl, you know, 2002 with Tampa Bay, or Woodson, or Peyton Manning, who's been to three Super Bowls. Peyton Manning been to three Super Bowls. But I'm interested in what Calvin Johnson gonna say. Sheila, I'm talking to you now. I know you watch this channel, Sheila. Y'all better pay this man this money, man. Y'all better bring this man back in the fold real quick. Like, Lomas Brown is due to be in the Hall of Fame. Countless other Lions are due. But this man is obviously a first ballot Hall of Famer. You can't. This man is on Tom Brady level or otherworldly level. And what he could talk about and what he could say to speak on the Lions in the national media. The national media believes that we are trash organization, bad GM, bad coach, garbage team, whatever. And they're not wrong. The record says, you know, every 30 years we win a playoff game. For the last 60 years, we haven't participated or went to a Super Bowl. We went to an NFC conference final or conference championship in 1991. And the last time we was in the playoffs was like, what, 2016 or 14? So it tells me a lot. We're not a storied organization. And those guys are going to speak. Those guys are going to thank their families. They're going to thank their colleagues, their wives, their mother, father, their humble beginnings. But Calvin's going to do that, and he can talk about this. He can talk about this team. Now, first, he can say thank you to the Fords for giving me the opportunity and drafting me that high, because you didn't have to. Okay, wide receiver was not a need at that time. It was a need, but it wasn't like crucial need. He was just the best among that class, and that class 2006-07, that class 2007 was amazing. Then he's going to probably talk about Stafford, and then that's where he's going to lose me. See, Stafford is cool. Stafford is a great QB, blah, blah, blah. But he's not a winner, and he hasn't been a winner. So I hope he doesn't shout out Stafford to get the wins you deserve or nothing like that. I hope there is no backshot compliment for the Detroit Lions. The way the Detroit Lions handle his injury shit, telling him to recant his statement about having a concussion and him getting high after every game, that shit might come up. See, this ain't just a video for fanfare. It's an actual video. Like, whoa. Like, the Lions did this dude dirty. I did a video on player safety as a must, part one and two. Part one was mostly about him, DeAndre Levy, how they handle injuries in his at his level, in his era, and how they were botched. How the protocol was just fucked up, neglected. This team was neglected by ownership. Neglected. I mean, think about it. This team was a joke. And he could rightfully shit on us, but I don't want him to do that. I want him to have some class. We don't deserve fucking Calvin Johnson. I say it to this day. I know there's some Lions fans that, you know, I know there's some fans that are going to be upset if Calvin Johnson says something or doesn't acknowledge the fan base or the ownership. Look, I just don't want no slap in the face. We did the motherfucker dirty. We did Stafford dirty. Covering up a 2-year back injury? Come on, man. Come on, man. And he could say and spill the beans on all that shit. He could. He ain't got nothing to lose. He already inducted in the Hall of Fame. What the fuck? He's 81. But to keep that relationship with Calvin, this is the only reason we're trying to keep this relationship for real. For real. As fans, we touched on the toxic fans. We touched on everybody. The ones that don't want to see him get his money back. The ones that don't want to see him win and succeed. Now he's going to have the microphone. It's going to be uncensored, uninhibited, and it's going to be candid. What's he going to say? He's going to talk about his family, Stafford, and in some capacity, the organization, who has fucked him a great amount of times. Restructured his contract, did all this weird shit. Then forced him to pay his money back. Didn't get it back until he about to mysteriously get in the Hall of Fame. Come on. Because just like Barry, the Lions did this man wrong. I'm sorry. On every emotional level. And then the fans at a certain point in time, y'all did him wrong. When it got too much to bear, y'all was like, oh, we pay him $1 million. No, you don't, bitch. I had to correct you, motherfuckers. Your little $100 goes to keeping the lights on. So, like, comment, subscribe. Tell me what you want or what you believe Calvin Johnson gonna say. It's gonna be interesting. We're gonna do a reaction to the speech. Hopefully, live reaction to the speech, because that shit gotta be epic. I just had to put this video out first because I'm a first type of dude, man. Other YouTubers ain't thinking about this shit right now. They think about fucking Patriot flags and shit. I'm thinking about this shit. And anything I think about, I turn into a video. So, love y'all.